Hello, dog gang. I have been MIA for a bit because I just started a new job, so I've had a lot to do. That's why you haven't heard from me in a while. So I just wanted to pop in here and talk about muzzle training and talk about why my dog has a muzzle sometimes. So I don't want you to come on here and be like, oh my God, what happened? Your dog is wearing a muzzle. Because nothing bad has happened and it's just part of our journey. And I feel like wearing a muzzle is so good. It has helped us a lot for confidence, both for him and for me. And for that, I'm grateful. Right, Maliki? But first, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and give us a thumbs up. And I want to talk about muzzle training because that's something I'm doing with my dog, Malik. And there is a lot of bad rep for muzzles. Like, people think all dogs that wear muzzles are aggressive or that they are super reactive, but there's so many reasons to wear a muzzle. Don't be judgmental to dog owners who have muzzles on their dog. I have muzzle on Malik because he doesn't like strangers. He eats stuff on the ground sometimes and I want to keep him safe because we live in a city. He is also very insecure in big crowds. So just having him in a muzzle makes him feel safer and me more confident. And confidence from the owner is so important. So if I can show him that I'm confident, it's more likely for him to feel safe and not react. Malik has a problem with handling. Different situations where handling is important and necessary, like the vet. The vet visits for me have been really stressful because I'm worried that he will nip someone or that he will growl or he will get himself or someone else into trouble. So by muzzle training him, I can be more confident going into the vet. And I am very lucky because I am having a great trainer around me. I'm having a great breeder who helps me out and a great vet. So in that sense, I am very understanding to his situation and I'm doing what I can to fix and help him to the best of my abilities. This is Malik's muzzle. It is a Sighthound muzzle. It only has one clip here. I know there is a few that has like over the eyes as well, but that's not something he prefers. And this muzzle is so easy to use. I actually got this from the breeder, so it's already worn in a bit soft, which makes it way easier because he had one before that was way stiffer and he didn't like it at all. When you train your dog to have a muzzle on, remember to make it a fun experience. Don't just force it on them when they've never used it before. That's never a good idea. It's always better to take it slow and to gradually get them used to it so it doesn't become the stressful event that they feel scared of. So I usually put this on a preset so I can fold it up like this. And then, let's see, candy. Always have treats. Wait. So now there's a treat in there. This is folded up. Wait. Back it up. Good boy. And I do this. Fold it over his ears. And there you go. Now he has it on. And he has this leather here, so it's not uncomfortable for him. And then, yeah, shake it off. And then when I take it off, I hold treats like this. So he sees the treat. And that means that I can unbuckle it, take it off, give him a treat. If they're uncomfortable at the vet, you don't want their only experience with the muzzle to be when they're going to the vet. You want them to have the muzzle on just like a regular day when nothing scary is happening. Otherwise, the muzzle means that, oh my God, something terrifying is going to happen to me. That's why I'm getting the muzzle on. But remember to make the muzzle a fun experience remember to get the right size. You can often go to your breeder or to the pet store or to the vet and get help. You can also measure their muzzle and see what's the right size. I will link down below where I got this one. But I also think it's important to break the stigma about muzzles. Malik is a great dog in 95% of the time, but he has those 5% of the times where I'm uncertain, and I don't want him or anyone else to get in trouble or end up in a crisis. So I do it for his protection, for my protection, for people's protections, for those 5% of times where he is insecure. And I think we have to break the stigma about that. And I also think that, especially on YouTube and on social media, people are talking always about how good their dogs are. And my dog is good too, but I think people always have these perfect dogs, and it can make you feel really shitty when your dog is not perfect 100% of the time. And I feel like I want to be part of breaking that stigma of owning a dog that is a bit reactive, that is uncertain, even though he had socialization. Because that's just partly his breed, partly his genetics from his litter, and partly just who he is as an individual. And we're learning to live with one another and what if works best for us. And if that could help you, that's what I want. And I will link some videos down below on muzzle training, how to get them desensitized to it. Also, I will link some Instagram accounts that also try to take away the stigma about muzzles that I have found really helpful and really strengthened me in my decision to make my dog muzzle trained. I hope this video was helpful for you, and I hope you enjoyed it. Until next time, take care of yourself, take care of your dog, and take care of each other.